Hey guys, my name is Cameron.
I'm Star.
And this is our home.
Welcome to the inside of the van. So this is our kitchen here. So our countertop is 6 feet long and is 18 inches wide. This looks like a real butcher block, but it's actually project panel with 1x3s around it. So the reason why we did that is because originally we purchased a real butcher block, but it was so heavy and it was $200. So we took that back and built this, and it's just been lighter, it's cheaper, it was like $30 to make this. So this is our sink. We went with a really big and deep sink so that we could fit dishes in here. Okay, so these are our seasoning racks, our seasoning jars. We got this idea from another YouTuber. It's a lifesaver, because like we have a lot of seasonings and we really even have more in here. We like to cook a lot. This is our cabinet area. We went with it being open, because honestly, when we were building this build, it was kind of hard figuring out how to connect the cabinets to here. So this was originally supposed to be temporary, but we loved it so much. And it's a great view. Like, you can see all the food, keep it nice and neat. So this is our, food storage and everything. So this is our mirror. We use this usually to like brush our teeth right here. You can just stand at the sink and see yourself, brush your teeth, things like that. So this is really cool. We got this from IKEA in here. We have this is gray water from dishes. And then we have the rest of our water storage. It's 2 6-gallon tanks. So this is our manual foot pump. We went with this because we wanted to save power. And also it was way easier to set this thing up. Like we said, we didn't have any experience with this build. So we just wanted things to be as easy as possible. So for cooking, we have a Coleman classic camp stove that we got from Walmart. So we just pull that out and usually cook outside. So these baskets, we have our food storage in here, and we actually put our food inside of baskets. Now the reason why we put them in here is, one, we heard that when you go boondocking, mice get in your van. Now hopefully that doesn't happen to us, but we heard that it could. So we don't want any mice attacking our food, so we put them in here, and also it keeps things organized. So when COVID first hit, our jobs had us stay home, and just being home a lot, we were on lockdown, so we couldn't really hang out with family or anything. So we wanted to be outside, but our neighborhood isn't really a safe neighborhood, so we couldn't really go outside and walk around. Sometimes they would be like shooting on the corner and crazy things like that. So we got the idea, why don't we buy a house? About a year earlier, we had finished paying off our debt. Cameron's major is in architecture and mine is in nursing. So we together had about $70,000 in student loan debt through those degrees. So we spent about a year paying that off and we were finally debt free. But for some reason, we thought it would be a good idea to go buy a house. We already have a house. Our house is paid off, but it's a really, like I said, in that neighborhood. So it wasn't an expensive house and we just wanted something bigger and better. So we went looking at houses, and in the area we wanted to be in, somewhere we could go outside and enjoy the nature, it was going to be about $300,000. So we thought about it and we were like, do we really want to go into debt? Because if we were to buy that house, we were going to like force ourselves to pay it off really quickly, put ourselves back on a debt-free journey. And we were just like, I don't think we want to do that. So after looking at houses and applying for a loan, we came across the idea to do van life.
Welcome to our living area. So here we have a 4-foot couch and it is 22 inches deep. We decided on these dimensions because in a lot of vans it can get a little tight in here. So this just allows us more operating room. Me and Star can go back and forth and do our daily needs without really running into each other and things like that. So under here there is the rest of our clothes storage. We can lift this bench seat up. These are on gas struts. And then we just have our power system here. And then we keep our dirty clothes and other laundry coats and things like that that we pack away for the hot season. So this is our DIY swivel table. We also got this idea from another YouTuber. Me and Star can sit comfortably side by side here. We like the position of this table because we can also use this tabletop for more food prepping space. So underneath our bed, we call this the Narnia door, and we just have our portable toilet that we have, and then we have our little buddy heater that we use on cold nights. Here we have our fridge. It is the Icecold VL75, so it is a 75 quart fridge. We have this side set up as our freezer right now, and then this side we have our fridge. So in learning about van life, we wanted to stay debt free, and this was a way that we decided that we should go. So a big thing that really resonated with me and Star during quarantine was just being free. You know, that experience really had our minds thinking on ways that we can detach ourselves from just the rudimentary things that we go through in life. And van life was a way that we could do that. We've only been on the road for 3 months, so we're really new to this, but I wouldn't take back these 3 months for anything. Also, the people that we've met so far on the road are just amazing people. And it's really a way that we wanted to build relationship with people and get to know people. All right, so welcome to the bedroom. We do have a queen size bed with Wise, so it's 60 inches. And then another thing that we love about the ProMaster is it's one of the widest vans that you can buy on the market. And I'm only 5'11", so after the build out, I am able to sleep this way, and that was big for us because we wanted to not compromise on living space. During our research, we found that a lot of people have to cut and modify their mattresses to fit them into a van if you want to sleep them this way. There's a lot of problems with that because a lot of mattresses have fiberglasses and other retardants for fire purposes, and that can be a big problem when, you know, cut the mattress and stuff can just get everywhere and you don't want to be breathing that stuff in. So we have two 2'6" by 6' dense memory foam as our base, and we stack those side by side. And then we have a 3-inch rubber latex mattress. And then on top of that, we used whatever insulation we have, Havelock wool, we used that as our top layer to just give us something soft and cushy to lay on. And then we enclose that in a mattress cover that zips, and then that's our mattress. I don't think we'll ever probably buy a regular mattress again. So shout out to Star. So here is our kind of clothes and storage wall. And then we just have my basket. And then we have Star's basket. These are just personal items that we use every day. And then we have a little reading nook. So we made the headboard with just a 5mm plywood as the backer. And then we use a 1-inch dense foam, and then we wrapped that with material, and then we just drilled it, and then we have two reading lights that we can use above the bed. So for the ceiling, we decided to go with a tongue and groove, and then how it's mounted is on the ProMaster, it has ribs every so often, and then I put 1x3s on the top, and then that gave me connection points to run all of the tongue and groove. All right, this is our Dodge Ram ProMaster 2500. It's the 159-inch wheelbase. It is a gasoline engine. Just have the standard tires on here. We might change to off-road very soon. So we decided to go with the basic white van for the stealth factor. For our solar setup, we have two 200-watt panels, so we have 400 watts in total. We have those linked in series, and they run to a portable power station called the Blue Eddy 2400. Welcome to the back of the van. These are our only two windows that we have in the van. This also increases our stealth factor. Next build, we may put a little smaller window on the side just to increase airflow, but we do have two max air fans currently, and we can use those in tandem to circulate air throughout the van. Welcome to the garage space. So in our garage, we have pretty much three main compartments. We have two smaller cubbies on each side that just have little random storage things, like have our laptop bag and little small things that we don't want to use every day. And then this central section has these two doors that can fully open. And then we have two water storage tanks here. I have some tools to do some things on the road. So these are 6 gallon jerry cans. We have these from Walmart. We have 4 of them, so we have 24 gallons of water storage on hand at all times, and that usually gets us about a week without having to fill up.
And another important thing to us is that we follow Jesus Christ of the Bible, and we were initially on the FIRE journey, if you guys are familiar with financial independence, retire early. So in that, we were really both workaholics, like working a lot of hours, just trying to save up as much money as we could so we could retire early. But in that, we felt like maybe we got a little sidetracked from God and wasn't giving him the time that he deserved. So we felt like getting into this lifestyle and being free with van life and not working so much. We aren't working at all currently, but eventually we will go back to work, but it'll be a little more balanced and we won't be focused on like just trying to build up a bunch of money and just get rich, because there's more to life than that. So this just allowed us to be free and spend time with God and sometimes just wake up and say, Lord, what do you want me to do today? So in that, we just love that freedom.
And now we just have that freedom and flexibility to do so. And that right there is just, you can't explain it.
So you guys can follow us on social media. We're nomadicnature_ on Instagram. And then we also have a YouTube channel that we're going to start filming our van life journey. That's NurseStar_RN.
I also do produce music. So you can email me at cameron.hw93@gmail.com. I have a ton of instrumentals and things like that. And I can also customize tracks and manipulate them, can get you what you want. Also, I do architectural floor plans and renderings, and am available for those services as well.
So thank you guys so much for checking out our home. We're happy to be able to do this tour. So thank you guys so much.
Peace.